This is Dilunika Edirachargi from Dilunika's Talk Show, and welcome back to another inspiring episode. So today I am going to interview a person who have interviewed many other celebrities. When I was searching details about his childhood, I realized that it's very important to us. It's not work if you're doing what you love every day. It is his words to the world. But before we meet our guest, just a quick reminder to go hit that subscribe button and also ring the notification bell. Also, don't forget to check out my Instagram account, which the link will show below. So now, it's time to meet our guest.
Don't ignore me. I will sit and scream. I know her.
Allow me to introduce Mr. Danu Innasithamby, or simply the Jaffna boy. Welcome, how are you?
Doing good, thank you for asking me to be on your show.
Yes, you look so victorious. Is it because of the victory of Jaffna Stallions? I think you must be very proud as the Jaffna boy.
Well, true, I didn't actually get a chance to follow the game so much this time around, but I know they won, so which is a good thing.
Yes, good.
Yeah.
Yes, so now it's time to get to the biggest questions, which is always please to give some few details about your childhood. Very important part. Yes.
Well, my childhood was not interesting like what you're doing right now.
Yes.
You're very, very talented, very brave to do this. I was always very shy and scared for a long time. I loved being on stage from the time I was very small. I loved acting, I loved singing, I loved dancing. Those are things I liked. I was not the smartest in school. I studied in three schools actually. I studied at St. Patrick's in Jaffna. Then I moved to Colombo, and for a little bit I studied at St. Benedict's for like 6 months in Cotena. Then I moved to St. Peter's College where I finished my studies. So that was my childhood. I was not the, not like you, who are like superstar worthy. I was just all right.
Normal. Okay, so please do tell us, how did you become a celebrity in the Sri Lanka media industry? I think it must be very hard though. Is it competitive?
Yes, I will not call myself a celebrity because I think it's not the correct word for it.
Okay.
I simply describe what I do as I'm grateful to the Lord for giving me a chance to do what I love doing.
Okay.
That's all I do. I have always enjoyed it. For me, I love to meet people, I like to talk to people. And it's interesting that somebody has made it a job and gives me money to earn out of it. But I'm grateful that I get to do it. I think anyone can be a celebrity in their industry, or famous, or known, or highlighted, as long as you do it from your heart. For me, I just love what I do, and I will do it as long as people want me to do it, because this job depends on what people appreciate. You can't force somebody to watch you, or you can't force somebody to like you. People have to like you and watch you because they want to. So until people want to see what I do, I will do what I like, and at that time I will leave.
Yes. So now please do tell us, what are the obstacles or challenges you have faced as you moved along your career path, and tell us, how did you overcome those?
Obstacles. Well, there are lots of obstacles every single day. This world is made out of different people, so we all can't understand everyone. So one person may react this way, one person might react the other way. Sometimes you can do something that could offend someone without your knowledge. So these are all obstacles that you face day in and day out. But every obstacle teaches you something, right? Like today I learned something, you learned something today. So we always learn something. Everyone learns something every day, and it just makes us understand that as long as this is a little tip that my mom gave me when I was very small, and I believed it ever since. She always says, when you go to sleep, ask yourself whether you have intentionally hurt someone. If you have not intentionally hurt someone, you can go to sleep. You don't even need to say a prayer. You can just go to sleep peacefully. But unintentionally. If you have intentionally hurt someone, then you need to ask forgiveness, because that is unintentionally hurting someone is just human. You don't know what you're doing, and that could just happen because we are not superpower people. But
we are not perfect.
Yeah. But if you intentionally do something to harm you or hurt you, then it's not a good thing. So that's all I believe in. I'm not somebody who runs from a church to another church. I'm very God-fearing, but only when it comes to these things, I'm like, did I do something wrong today to someone? No. Okay, then, I did this. No, I should have actually liked me. So if I can call and apologize, or if I can do something to rectify the situation, I'll do it. But I'm not a saint. I'm like a stubborn soul, I promise you that.
Yes. So now, please do give a little message to our younger audience.
Okay, younger than you?
everyone, just it's everybody.
Okay, so...
or the new generation.
New generation, of course, you all are just millennials. A new generation, all what I could say is, just do what you love, do what you really care about, and love abundantly, even if you don't get it in return. Just show a lot of love, because it's always good. Because in life, you'll always meet nice people who will love you back.
Wow, that was so amazing. And finally, I have one last question.
Okay.
It might be the hardest.
Oh, really?
Yes, it's okay. Very hard.
Tell me.
What do you think about my show?
I really like it. I'm so happy that you're doing it, because let me just think, what did I do when I was 12? God knows, I don't know what I did when I was 12, it was a long time ago. But congratulations, I'm so proud of what you're doing, and I must say you have a very supportive mum and sister who are with you 24/7. You know the best part? I don't have mummy.
Yes, I know.
And when you have them, you have to treasure them, because they will give everything. Even if they have to sell, borrow, steal, they'll do whatever they have to do to look after you. So you're doing a great job, and I think sky is the limit.
So,
what do you want to do when you grow up?
I want to become a news reader plus a lawyer. I want an international news reader.
Oof.
Yes.
At that time also, would you call me for something?
Yes, surely.
Call me onto the big set, okay? I want to come. Don't ignore me. I will sit and scream. I know her.
I'm not ignoring anything.
Okay.
Well.
Good.
Yes.
And you're good. You become a lawyer, then you can help me sue everyone who I want to sue. Yeah, yes. Good.
That's
good.
It.
We have got everything sorted then. Yes. Super. Okay.
Amazing.
Yeah. If you also become a doctor, then free consultation for me.
Oh, okay. Actually, I don't have any idea to go with it.
Just do that as a easy for me.
I like to do what I like.
Yeah.
Yes.
True.
No. True. Thank you so much for joining with me and spending your precious time. Also thanking everyone for watching this video, and I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to give a like to this video and subscribe to my channel. Stay tuned, because more videos are coming soon. Till then, stay safe. This is Dilunika Edirachar from Dilunika's Talkshow. Goodbye.